Hi, Baruch Hashem. What a beautiful letter. I mean, it's a certain amount of koach, strength that's necessary to survive the end of days. The Gemara in Masechet Sanhedrin, they ask Rabbi Eliezer ben Hyrcanus, one of the giants of all giants, what's going to save us at the end of times? It says Torah and Gemilut Chasadim. Now, Gemilut Chasadim, we've talked about many, many times, about how someone has to go out of their way to save Jews and do things that are above and beyond. But what does it mean, Torah? Torah, why? You just open a book and that's it? You fulfilled one main thing to get you to have survival at the end of times? What does it mean, Torah? Torah means to be a person of emet, standing up for Torah, fighting for Torah, to thick and thin, whether it makes sense to the world or it doesn't make sense to the world, whether it's acceptable or not acceptable, that's what it means. So when Am Yisrael was in Yam Suf, they're all scared to death. They have no idea what to do. There's a sea that never ends in front of them. There's Egyptians that want them to end behind them. And there's scorpions and snakes on both sides. Where are you going to go? Nachshon ben Aminadav. Nachshon ben Aminadav, the leader of the tribe of Yehuda, says, if Hashem already brought us here, that means He wants us to go forward. And he moved forward and went into the ocean up to the point where the sages say he started drowning. His belief got to the point where he was willing to put his life on the line. Why? For Torah. For Hashem Yitbarach. For Hashem Yitbarach. He went in there, and right when he started swallowing water, that's when Hashem split the sea. Why? On his merit. On his merit, he saved the entire nation. On his merit. And that's why until this day he's known. That's why until this day the Mashiach is going to come from Nachshon ben Aminadav. Before David HaMelech, before Shlomo HaMelech, it had to be from the tribe of Yehuda. Who got the merit? Nachshon ben Aminadav. So when you stand up for Torah, when you stand up for the Emet, that's what you're standing up for. You're standing up for the truth. Putting a mitpachat on your head instead of one of this avodah zarah, immodest wigs that unfortunately many of the women of Am Yisrael are putting on. Unfortunately, some because of ignorance, some because of other reasons. When you're standing up for the truth, when they're even telling you to their face, you wearing it, you're going to get fired. You wearing it, you're going to get thrown out of the keilah. You wearing it, blah, 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 all these threats. You're saying, I don't care about your threats. I don't care about anything you say. All I care about is Hashem Yitbarach. And that's also what the things you can teach your kids for the rest of your life. What's the lesson of Chanukah? What are we going to learn from Chanukah? What are we going to learn? What did the Hashmonaim say? What did the leader say? Mi le Hashem elai. Whoever's for Hashem is with me. Whoever's against Hashem is... When you stand up for Hashem like this, and you tell the world, whoever's with Hashem is with me. Whoever's not, I care less what their opinions or their threats or whatever they're saying is. It's irrelevant, because once it's against Hashem, it's meaningless. And that's what we learned in last week's parasha with Yaakov Avinu told his two wives. He said, your father Lavan Rasha cheated me for 20 years, and he changed my maskoret, my income 100 times. We had a deal, he changed it. We had a deal, he changed it. We had a deal, he changed it. Every day he changed the deal. 100 times he changed the deal. 100 times, imagine. You sign a contract, he changes the deal 100 times. But there's a very, very important words in the Pasuk that some people missed. Yaakov Avinu says, but Hashem did not let him succeed. But Hashem did not let him succeed. Velo netano Elohim le'arai imadi. Hashem did not permit him to harm me. That's the key. Why? Mi le'Hashem elai. Why? Because I stood up for Hashem. I was honest. I stood up for Hashem. That's all I need in the world. So this is what you can teach your kids. This is what Nachshon ben Aminadav. This is what makes you Bat Israel. This is what makes you the daughter of Yaakov Avinu. Why you stand up for Hashem when it doesn't make sense? When everyone's against, that's when you stand up for Hashem. That's when it counts. That's Akedat Yitzchak. That's the greatest thing in the world. You should be proud of yourself. Your husband should celebrate your name. Celebrate your name. Mamash, celebrate your name and be mamash. Thank Hashem for having a schut to stand with such an amazing person that's willing to stand up for Hashem. And you obviously celebrate him as well for being supportive. The key is you have something to be proud of. Why? You stood up for Hashem when it counts. Be'ezat Hashem, many, many more blessings will come to you. Hashem Yibarach will give you parnasah tova, atzlacha rabba, refuah shlema, refuah nefesh, refuah guf. All the blessings in the Torah will come true in this world and the next for you and for all of the ones that love you. Kol tov.